Company Command! This is First Platoon! We've lost the square! We can't hold it!
So finally, the game no one expected 10 years down the line has just been announced, Space Marine 2. I'll just say that again, it's been 10 years, a decade, since the last Space Marine game. And first things first, what has been announced is simply that there's a new game. Excellent. And it has a very well put together trailer, also excellent. I would however note that nearly all 40k games tend to have spectacular trailers because the universe itself lends to obviously epic traders. 40k games themselves, as everybody knows, can have a wild spectrum of quality. We dare not speak the heretical curse words mobile game or free to play. And quite honestly, when it comes to games and traders and showcases, speculating about, oh, the guns don't feel quite right, I'm not sure about this movement or that movement, it's an initial trailer, let's wait until we see more. And I'll get to discussing the trailer itself later on in the video, because you've already likely seen it 20 times by now, and all I mostly have to say is, ooh, pretty, and that it feels accurately imposing to me. So the short version, it's a very evocative trailer, as a trailer should be, just like the trailer for the 9th edition was evocative, just like the Kill Team cinematic for the Krieg Orcs showdown was evocative. They stir something in you, which is what trailers are designed to do. However, unlike most trailers when it comes to Space Marine, the cinematic may well be not a huge step away from the gameplay we're likely to experience, and that, my friends, is why you get a strong gut reaction from this than you might do otherwise. I feel like we are inching ever closer to 40k being realised in a bigger form. And many of you have left comments on older videos I made which were talking about how you will recall potentially schemed 40k TV series that Games Workshop actually announced or shows starting production. Now, we have not heard anything to suggest that those are not still happening, but we also have not heard any further news about them. So as far as we can know, those are still in production. Now, Space Marine itself as a game is what you would call almost a cult game at this point. It was not widely lauded upon its release, it had pretty mediocre reviews, and they made heavy mention of repetitive gameplay, were generally middle of the road in their praise. So let's just roll back and have a reminder of some of the hot takes given by mainstream games media back in 2011. Worth remembering that the original Space Marine game was produced by Relic, and this new Space Marine iteration is going to be a Focus Interactive Saber iteration. Of the original Space Marine game, PC Gamer said, quote, "Space Marines are the most boring thing, and Space Marine is not a long game, it's not a complicated game, and there's little incentive to replay the campaign." But they did also note that the darkness of the far future is less grim when constant war feels so good. Eurogamer said, "Whereas science fiction shooter developers often tell us there are many more stories to be told, in a universe we've spent two or three games plugging with bullets thanks to Relic's fine detailing, Space Marine intuitively feels like just one story in a vast universe of many more, and we don't need to be told so." GameSpot added, "What Space Marine does best is capture the spirit of its universe. The Ultramarine's weathered armor is so heavy and hardy, they don't so much wear it as it wears them. As you push through battle-worn trenches, the Orc's makeshift machinery erupts from the ground, shaking the earth. Roaring greenskins in rocket packs rush past, providing a touch of comedy amid all the carnage, and such carnage it is." However, they also sadly added that, "The story, on the other hand, is as dry as the battlefields are sodden." To wit, the opening cutscene begins with a sequence featuring the ever-exciting storytelling device called Words Displayed on a Monitor. And for obvious reasons, I didn't bother to look up what IGN had to say. However, to come back to those boring, those ever-exciting Words Displayed on a Monitor, did you mean the boring sequence which created one of the most regularly stated quotes of any 40k game in the past decade, the immortal words of the Imperium, "Strategic value, absolute"? Yes, that boring opening sequence, which for me is one of the most fabled 40k opening sequences of any game. Let's remind ourselves of that. Now, I should note that this is my opening sequence for Space Marine that I cut down, but even this, just in the beginning here, you can't just call this text on screen, "strategic value, absolute." This puts you immediately into feeling like you're right in the Imperium. You're seeing all of the communications. Unacceptable. And the music as well is so evocative in this opening sequence. Adeptus Astartes Ultra. This whole opening sequence was, for me, perfect. It feels so much like everything I enjoy with the verse. I cut the bit where they're all chatting. This is the next most emotional part for me. Titus is going in to land on the Orc barges, and it's this bit right here which gets you every time. They're shooting up at him, and then look, this is everything that's 40k. He's this tiny little dot in the sky, he's coming through this hellfire, and then bang, you're into the game. It's perfect. So with the original Space Marine game, right from the outset, you got an amazing feel of what the Space Marine game was going to be all about. And it's something that 40k fans have gone back to again and again. I've played the game through multiple times just for the experience of being able to be a Space Marine. And we certainly could use more games like Space Marine, specifically in their mechanics, potentially with even more freedom. Hired Gun was a step in the right direction. It was, of course, a shame that Eternal Crusade turned into such a doomed ending. Its vision to bring a 40k interpretation of Planetside 2 ended up being a goal that was just too high to reach for, but that's another story entirely. The point is, people's appetite for more open, non-turn-based 40k games is clearly there, and perhaps if Space Marine 2 is a success, it will begin to encourage other offerings, the possibilities thereafter, of course, wide open. With this release, there will undoubtedly be additional info via Warhammer community, perhaps in the next 24 hours, 48 hours, and as is nearly always the case, any posts I'll link to directly below this video in the notes as and when they go live, so check back for any additional details. Now, it might seem weird to have bothered to go back and look at 2011 past reviews of the original Space Marine game. We're talking about the new game here. But I thought it was important to demonstrate the underestimation of how well regarded the Space Marine game would become in the 40k community over the years. Because what people began to find with Space Marine is that it's not a complicated game, it's not full of weird factional imbalances or other weird meta, it is simply a very pure game. You're a Space Marine, you get dropped into a world, you fight your way through to the end, and then the Inquisition tells you, "You're done, sunshine, let's go." Despite, of course, the Inquisition being seemingly the entire problem in the first place, but of course, what else would you expect to see? Now, Space Marine was one of those games that a non-40k fan would just not feel the same evocative immersion that somebody who was already deeply immersed in the world of 40k would. In fact, this is typical of most 40k games. And it's pretty obvious and understandable. Somebody who just enjoys games might stack Space Marine against, like, Gears of War, and then break down all the gameplay details that make one superior to the other. But for 40k fans, this is not really the end of the issue. It's not about just pure mechanical comparison. This is, in fact, a problem I myself have. Despite many 40k games falling short of what I would expect from other games, the very fact that it is 40k immediately somehow in my mind lets me stack it higher and get away with far less than what I would ordinarily qualify as a benchmark standard. And that's just me being honest. I'm biased to 40k. I know that must be a shocking revelation. It's why with Darktide, which has been mysteriously quiet for some time, I don't think anybody is really expecting that to be the most complicated of games, but people are expecting it to be a lot of fun to play. And here comes the inevitable concern though. While Focus Interactive are the publisher behind Space Marine 2, that's right, like I said, it's not Relic now, and Focus have been handling the 40k verse for some time with success in games like Battlefleet Gothic 1 and 2, Space Hulk Tactics, Deathwing, which again, Deathwing is a funny one. It sort of had a pretty frosty reception, but I think people have been sort of warming to it and coming back to it simply because you get to play as a Terminator. Then you've got Necromunda Underhive Wars, Hired Gun. The developer studio behind Space Marine 2 is Saber Interactive though. And Saber Interactive is known for World War Z, SnowRunner, and WWE Battlegrounds. SnowRunner though, is a supremely enjoyable game. I've sunk quite a lot of time into it, but SnowRunner isn't a 40k third person hack and slash death fest. In fact, it's about as polar opposite as you can get, which is why I'm very curious slash excited to see what potentially is on offer with this new Space Marine game. Because when you get down to it, Space Marine as a game wasn't the most complex affair, and I think honestly, providing you understand the source material, almost any good developer studio should be able to bang out a Space Marine game. But I'm also feeling very cautious. But there are positive small signs, like the inclusion of actual gameplay at the end of the trailer. This is very unusual for a developer to show so early what we could assume is if not actual gameplay, then at least in-game graphics. And it's suggestive that they want to show people not just a swish trailer, but actually some gameplay to let people see what they're capable of handling the look, the feel of the series, which I think it actually does. And it somewhat helps to assuage my concerns about a studio never having tackled in recent times a 40k game. It's also reassuring that Focus are handling this game because Focus, I would say, have at least been one of the more consistent of publishers when it comes to 40k games. And it's worth remembering that through Focus, we have had some of the most visually stunning moments of critical 40k lore events in the Fall of Cadia and the Battlefleet Gothic series. Now I think what we all want to be sure of is that we see the experience for Space Marine remain true to itself. It's a single player narrative slashing experience, and that's what it needs to be. Saber and Focus and its other 40k dev studios have an opportunity here to cement themselves as one of the leading 40k game publishers. And that's a big prize to reach for. And all they have to do to claim that prize is not screw this up by turning Space Marine 2 into a buggy cash grab. Now, I'm not saying it's going to be, but just don't give us crappy microtransaction mechanics, follow the lore, because it's all set out there for you already. You don't have to dick around with it or reinterpret it, just follow the lore. Lastly, just playtest the hell out of the game before release. Don't make a buggy mess that people want to wash their hands of on day one. Deliver for the fans a competent, mechanically enjoyable visual feast, and the playing audience will love you for it. Just deliver a quality, well-executed game, and people will come back for more again and again. Now, earlier today, I made a community post and asked for your thoughts on the trailer. To no surprise, there were many, and overall people were positive, but with mixed reactions. Let's just look at a couple of those. 36 Lessons says that what made Space Marine great was it was, in a sense, taking a Warhammer 40,000 novel and making it into a third-person shooter hack and slash. The story was solid, not too over the top, good voice acting, and simple objective progression. Hopefully they take a page from the first one and stick to the tried and true feeling of 40k. The PvP was great too, no need for microtransactions. Awesome says, what I want to know is how Titus managed to get free of the Inquisition's clutches. That is true, we need to find that out. And usually when the Inquisition gets you, they either kill you, or if you have some kind of useful trait or skill, they recruit you for some inquisitorial stuff. Considering he has some kind of connection to the warp, Titus just seems to be carrying on as normal, which is a bit bizarre. Again, I mean, they're not going to tell us all that in a trailer though, are they? Also, I hope we have our revenge on Leandros, indeed. iPirateArg says, I'm very excited. I played the original on launch when it came out and loved it. Now that I'm actually getting into the 40k lore and the hobby side of things, I'm super excited. Trailer was awesome. Gameplay at the end looked really well put together, but it's early, so we'll see. I would like a third-person action-based game on the Grey Knights or Death Watch. That would be sweet. Rob says, looks great, but my couple of concerns from seeing a bit of gameplay at the end, bolters sound like a normal rifle and the movement seems floaty. It didn't look like it had the same weight as the first one. We'll have to wait for a full gameplay reveal, but hopefully it will be just early footage used. Colin says, the hype is real. What little gameplay we saw, thank the Emperor they saw fit to include any, looks baller. The NIDs look magnificent, as do Marines themselves. If they can approach the feel and fun of the previous installment, I'm a happy man. Still, although I am hella excited, let's keep in mind that we've yet to see any dedicated gameplay videos and should take everything we've done with a grain of salt or two, and that many games as of late have had the tendency to be quite, well, shit. Looking at you, Battlefield 2042, Cyberpunk, and honestly the majority of the games this and the previous year. Black Templar says, pretty disappointed they go with a more interesting chapter. Which chapter do you think? Ultramarines are really lacking in character. How dare you? There's some much better options that would have been attracted to an outsider. Is this Bricky in disguise? I think if they'd done Blood Angels, they would have attracted a massive vampire audience. It's not Bricky, because he would have been talking about curs otherwise. DLC in the future with different campaigns would be a good option. I think the best option would have been Death Watch, because of how interesting and varied you could make the campaign and weapons used. I think they've really missed a trick. Well there. So as to be expected, community opinion, some people mega hyped for it, some people not too sure, some people don't like some bits. Basically, let's wait and see. But what it really comes down to, ultimately, is the pure enjoyment of the experience. And for 40k fans, Space Marine was always enjoyable because essentially you just get to tour through the world of the 40k verse, and who wouldn't want to do that? Plus, the story, whilst not exactly the most complex or grandiose, does enough to lead you through and at least maintain attention, backed by solid gameplay mechanics that were as simple as they were addictive. And I have always said, visuals, no, not the most important. Story, no, not the most important, but I do like a good story. Mechanics are what make a game. Enjoyable, addictive mechanics are what keep you playing. And I've mentioned this in the past. The multiplayer also I will make mention of for the original Space Marine game. It was bizarrely quite good and balanced, which is very strange for these kind of games, but it actually was fairly enjoyable. And while it was sort of like an undiscovered pearl, actually, and while it was still active and people were playing it, it really was a pretty good time, and since then, some have even tried to resurrect it periodically. So it'll be interesting to see whether they do anything with that, but it really must be an afterthought. The single player campaign is what people are coming for. And as I said earlier, I was very pleased to see that on the back end of this cinematic trailer, they actually included a few momentary clips of gameplay. This is very positive, and we'll look at those slower in a moment. But often, as I said, game studios tend to shy away from any gameplay in their first reveals, especially 40k games. But the sight of actual, clear gameplay, or at least in-game visuals, is very positive. It means they're confident enough to show us, and that is a good sign. Secondly, of that gameplay, it looks very much what you would want to see from this series, i.e. it doesn't look like they've messed around much with the core gameplay, and that's another positive. This is a major problem generally with game sequels because, as some people know of course, there is always this seeming emphasis with game studios to do more every time with a game. Even when a previous game is considered as being perfect or it's sold really, really well, they've still got to piss around with stuff and then they often end up ruining what they had. And really what it comes down to is people in game studios just wanting to put their own mark on things. Not to mention those studios can often have a reasonably high turnover game to game, because production of titles can take several years, and this means that a game produced years and years down the line will likely have fewer of the people who worked on a successful title before. You see this all the time, and what happens is it leaves you with a sequel of a game that is often a bit of a shambles, or at least a hollow shell of its former self, usually because the new people coming in want to make their mark, which means changing a lot of stuff that didn't really need changing. Now I'm also going to say something that I've said many times before. Gamers are often their own worst enemy, because many gamers put a lot of pressure audibly on studios to do more, 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 give us more, give us more, give us more, instead of just being merely satisfied with what people might call a reskin, which is essentially delivering the same mechanics and so forth, but just providing a slightly different story or setting. And what it comes down to is, like, what do you want? Do you want more of what you know that's already good and as enjoyable as it ever was? Or do you want the studio to end up messing around with a format trying to satisfy everybody, which you can never do, and in the end, they serve up something that is ostensibly new, but in the process ruined everything that worked before? Looking at you, Battlefield, but that's a whole other thing I'm resigned to no longer discussing. All I will say is we should fear the day that EA gets its filthy claws into the 40k franchise. Emperor save us from that ever happening. So the question is, what do I want from this Space Marine game? I just want more of the same. I want to hack and slash and slaughter my way through the Xenos horrors of the Tyranid. I want to jump back into the ground and smash my way through and wield a huge array of weaponry, all while touring through a 40k feast for the eyes, and if possible, something of a story to go along with it. Is that too much to ask? I think it's something like this. Sometimes you go to a movie because you want to get a rich, deep piece of storytelling, and so you go and you sit and absorb and you mentally ponder just what it all means. Other times you go to the movies and you deliberately go to a cinema at 11 a.m. on a Tuesday so you can watch Fury Road alone, as I did, and you sit in the middle of the cinema so you can be visually and audibly assaulted. And you need little more than that to get a good experience. I want Space Marine 2 to be my Fury Road experience. Yes, Titus, blah blah blah. He's a decent Space Marine. He killed some enemies of humanity along the way, and at the end the Imperium kind of screwed him over. But honestly, what did anybody expect? It's actually the perfect ending. I would have been surprised had that not happened, quite honestly. Now, Titus is seemingly returned after having crossed the Primaris Rubicon. What a shocker. He's got another couple of skull rivets to boot, so we know it's not a prequel, it's post. So good going. I'm intrigued for the story to be sure, but you might be surprised to know that it's actually lower down my list of critical things in this game, the story that is. What I want the most from Space Marine 2 is visual overload, slash, hack, gore. I basically want this to be third-person 40k Doom. Give me that, I'm happy. So let's have a look at this trailer, and just to be clear, these are my unscripted thoughts. I'm not somebody who's going to start overanalyzing every single pixel in the trailer for secrets, details, all that nonsense, because I just do not have the time. Let's have a look at this. So first up, I really like the scale here. I like the scattered broken communications. You get the real feeling some big problem is occurring. Obviously Thunderhawk gunships. The Nids are like, straight away, they're very unhappy because they know what's coming. Coming in, we just got the Imperial Guard, obviously getting horribly, horribly slaughtered. That's their job. Good job, you're doing well. In come the Emperor's Angels to smash everything up. I think I saw comments saying that the Space Marines didn't look like they had any weight, which is a funny thing to say considering that. I know what people mean though, it does have a slightly floaty aspect to it, but it's just the style of animation. I don't think it's like anything to be concerned about. I like the Marines coming in here and just devastating, not even anything to be concerned about. Get a larger form, which I think is perhaps a Gaunt, comes and tries to lunge at the Marine, just gets absolutely bisected. And that is brutal. It's a good sign for me because it's the gore. It's the gore level you want to see in a 40k game. You don't want anything diluted down. And again, that's what you need to be there. So then when he comes up to the Tyranid Warrior and you get this classic chainsword sparks flying all over the place with the chitin of the Tyranid, pulls the pistol, stuns the Warrior before going in for the kill move. Now, my question is, will that kind of stun mechanic be in the game? Because, of course, in the original Space Marine game, you had the ability to stun your enemies, then go in for the kill. I'm wondering if that's a nod to that. And then finally, of course, he goes full Khalgar and the head is off. Now, the bit that I especially love next is the awe of the Imperial Guard. It's so good, it's so lore accurate. You had that with the original Space Marine game as well, that whenever you would walk through areas of the city in Angria, you would have the Imperial Guard kneeling down, looking up at these Marines. Because remember, most humans never get to actually see a Space Marine. They never actually get to see Astartes, because Astartes are so few and far between. And I just love that look of awe in the guardsman's eyes, you know, this sense that something he never thought he'd even be able to see. Again, looking at the guardsman's eyes, interesting how they have this purple look to them. It makes you wonder, could that be something like the Tyranids poisoning the world and he's already got this in him? Or is it the Great Rift? Because remember, when you look up at the Great Rift, it can actually start to kind of poison you. You look at the Cicatrix Maledictum too much, infect your mind and body with the darkness of the void. This is something which happened to people on Cadia as well. And then finally we get this beautiful awe-inspiring shot of the world falling, loads of Tyranid things still coming down, and you've got Titus with his head rivets, obviously, got a story to tell us. And then we come to the gameplay. Like I said, something we didn't expect to see, and I'm just going to go through slowly here. First of all, we're coming in on the newer jump packs, the kind of grav shoots. Comes in, smashes the smaller forms away. Again, very similar to that original Space Marine game, and the force with which he's coming in there. You can see the ground literally cracking open with sort of molten looking below. Then over the shoulder, nice to see that over shoulder action. Coming through here, running through the city. Again, the visuals very similar to that of Space Marine, so what we want to see. The only thing I'm not too sure about here, the sort of the fact that he's in shadow, the colors look very contrast, dark, oversaturated almost. I'm not a big fan of that color palette there, so I'm not sure whether that's going to be something which changes or whether they put some kind of different filters on it or whatever, I don't know. And then here, where he's just absolutely mashing through the horde of the Nids, looking awesome. Finally came up to some big tower spire, absolutely surrounded by perhaps gargoyles and all those kind of Tyranid forms. So yeah, that's my thoughts on the trailer. Overall, looks pretty good. Showcases us a good range of things, and it felt pretty epic and awe-inspiring to me. So my final thoughts are fairly to the point, because what else can you say right here and now? Don't screw this up, Focus and Saber. I'm hopeful that Focus, who have been involved in publishing 40k games for many years, now have their finger on the pulse of the community, and they understand that yes, originally Space Marine was just your standard fare hack and slash Space Marine adventure. Over time though, it's become much more, the characters more noteworthy, and the experience aged somehow like a fine wine, or sort of anyway. Maybe that's going a little bit overboard. But basically, people appreciated Space Marine for what it was no frills, it was good mechanical gameplay, and it put you, the player, into the 40k verse, right where you wanted to be, mashing through orcs. I think a lot is riding on this release in the game sphere. People are breathing heavily for a solid 40k experience that puts you right into the action as an Astartes. So let's hope this one delivers. Tell me your thoughts below, and I'll follow this series up later along the line. Thanks as always, more lore coming soon. I'll see you next time.
Oh, not much feels better than unleashing absolute hell in this game. Seriously. I like the music. I like how at the end it's just like, this has been another day in the Imperium. This is just like a normal day in the Imperium. I kind of want to start over again now. You guys want to start over?